Thank you, Professor Kannan. While the faculty members who participated in the FDP, and all 3 lakh faculty members will be trained like that, would become aware of these things. But we particularly wanted heads of the institutions also to appreciate this, so that they could facilitate this changeover, because this requires both a mindset changeover, and this actually requires much more work for the faculty member teaching that course. Believe me, all of us might have attempted it sometime or the other, but to set proper multiple choice questions so that the understanding is reflected is not easy at all. And it typically requires 3 times more effort than setting question papers like describe this or write short notes, etc. Okay, so this is something that is detailed. We'll be slightly delayed, so please excuse me for that. But as I mentioned, for the blended education, where we would like our students to learn both from MOOCs and from face-to-face interaction that normally happens, the FDPs will permit our teachers to be trained on how to use the flipped classroom properly, so that they can supplement the online courses that students do with a different style of teaching and learning there. But for the benefit of such teachers, what they normally lack is, there are 1 lakh students who are doing a MOOC. My 100 students are also doing that MOOC. Now each individual student will know how he or she is performing. But as a teacher, I should also know how my 100 students are doing in the MOOCs course, so that I will know whether I am complementing things properly or not, etc. For that, we have built a dashboard. And this dashboard is attached to our open source platform. I had a chat with Professor Sahasrabuddhe. He has promised that, he has rather suggested that we should also incorporate this blended MOOCs facility in Swayam itself. So as the Swayam evolves, in coming months and years, we'll be doing that. But for the time being, it is available on our open source MOOCs platform, which is what we'll be using for the end. So I'll request my colleague to just make it as short as possible, about 10 minutes time. So this is the dashboard which a faculty member in a college or head of the institution in the college will be able to use to see how, suppose as head of the institution, let's say your students are attending such blended MOOCs courses, say 3 courses. Say one in thermodynamics, one in signals and systems, one in computer programming. This is what we ran last year. Now the individual teachers in your college who are teaching these courses will be able to monitor the performance of their students in the online activities individually for their courses. But head of the institution or a nominated coordinator would be able to observe the performance of all students doing such courses, whether 1, 2, or 3, independent of how many teachers are teaching that course. So this is a facilitation for monitoring that we have created. While they set it up, I would like to share with you some of the initial thoughts that we had in a meeting after the first day of the activities here. We do believe that the associate faculty members should be compensated as a recognition by some remuneration. Tentatively, we have decided that we'll fix the remuneration to somewhere between 6,000 to 7,000 rupees per FDP. We do presume that the corresponding heads of the institutions where these associated faculty are situated will permit them to do this activity. And while they will be naturally doing their normal load, but if it is possible, at least informally, as an encouragement, if the heads of the institutions could facilitate their activity, that will be nice. We'll also be running these FDPs now, continuing the self-sustenance model. We have decided that all participating faculty who participate in the future FDPs will have to pay a charge to IIT Bombay this time, amounting to about 1,450 or about 1,500 per FDP. We have considered opinions of many people, and most people feel that teachers paying 1,500 rupees for an FDP is not a very large amount of charge. We would expect the institutions to support this by sponsoring this charge. This money is to be paid to IIT Bombay. as charge for that FDP. We have been promised by MHRD that funds will be released for supporting conduct of such FDPs over the next 1 year. So 4 or 5 FDPs that we will run over the next year, wherever association of remote centers is required or associate faculty is required, the honorarium to associate faculty and the cost of support at every remote center will be paid by the project. Similarly, for the limited period for which the participating faculty will attend the face-to-face sessions at remote center, their TADA will also be paid as long as the funding comes from the government. But eventually, as the chairman said, we have to move towards a self-sustenance model in which 3 people should contribute. One is the faculty member himself or herself who is benefiting. Second is the institution for which the faculty member works, because if the faculty member becomes well endowed into using this technology, the quality of education in their own institute will go up. So some support or sponsorship should expect. The third sponsorship we expect is to continue support from CSR and alumni activities that we said. But this notional charge for FDP will be collected. We are connecting a payment gateway to our registration system, so that we'll be announcing the FDP almost immediately in April. I'm also happy to tell you that the first FDP, which is the foundation course in ICT, will largely run as a MOOC program. There will be associate faculty members who will be used to clarify doubts in AVU sessions, for which we are making those facilities available. The second course on FDP, which is on pedagogy, that will require a little more intense interaction in face-to-face sessions. And that is where remote centers will have to be participating, for which, as I said, if MHRD releases funds in April, May, we'll be using those. But first FDP we shall be announcing, which will start from April, May itself. Since it is online, it is only suggested, we'll be writing to all heads of the institutions, but please take this message back that most of your faculty members, doesn't matter what subject they teach, and your colleague heads in other neighboring institutions, if you would convince them the utility of such FDPs, that will be useful.
Today I am here to give demonstration of information system for blended MOOCs. Basically, the blended MOOCs program started in June 2015. It is a combination of the online courses and a classroom teaching. Suppose I am a teacher from the Ideal Engineering Institute and participating in IIT Bombay's blended MOOCs program. So with my classroom teaching and my own assignment and test, my students are also watching the videos and doing assignments from the IIT Bombay X. I would factor some marks from the MOOCs program into the final grade of my subject. So now I am logging as a teacher in the system. So Sita Devi is the suppose the name of the teacher. She is teaching the demo course in the IIT Bombay X. So this system is very simple to tag your student and view their progress, how they are performing in the IIT Bombay X. To see the evaluation policy and the grading criteria of the course, here the course detail tab is present. In this, the important net related to the course, evaluation policy, grading criteria, everything you will see in this tab. Until up to the today's date, 2 assignments are done for this course. Now you have to tag your student so you are able to see the progress of your student. So upload students information. You have to upload students data in one particular format. Here the template is given. So in the template the format is given. So I will show you. This is the template. In this you have to write the roll number, username and the email. Roll number is the student local roll number for the institute. Username is the IIT Bombay X username. It is the case sensitive. Email is also the IIT Bombay X email using which student is registered in a IIT Bombay X. So I have one file having some data. So I will show you. This is the file having some data. It has the 18 total students. So I will now upload the students' data.
Something that teachers will do at the beginning of the course. So I have these 50 or 100 students, their local roll number, their IIT Bombay ID, which I will collect. And for that course, I will upload that file. So that our MIS system will now know that out of 1 lakh total students doing this MOOC, these 100 are from this institution, these 70 are from this institution, etc.
So I upload the students' data. Total number of students tagged in your class is 18. And total students tag is 16. Students which are not validated by the system is 2. It gives the error messages. Username is not valid. Here on the left hand side, you can see the user manual. Here you can see the various error messages if you got while uploading the file. So the error messages username is not valid means either the username is incorrect for the student or user or the student is not enrolled in the course. So you have to ask the student if the username is correct or not. So if the it is a correct, then it will get, or if it is a wrong.
Let me explain this part. These 100 students' data who are my students, their roll number is something I know personally. But what is their email ID on IIT Bombay X or what is their username, I would not know. This information will be given by students. Now there could be mistakes while writing the spelling, there may be mistakes while entering, and that's the only cause where this error will come. So whenever error comes, the teachers have to go back to those students, get the corrected information. Sometimes the student has given some information, but the student has not enrolled for that course online. So again, that will show in it. This is just a bookkeeping kind of thing. At the beginning of the semester, ensure that all your student records are present.
So in the student details, you can see the students which I have uploaded. Here two facilities are given. First is edit and unenroll. In the edit, you only able to edit the roll number of the student because the username and the email ID you can't edit because it is an IIT Bombay X username and the email ID. And unenroll the student means you can unenroll the student from the course. So if I unenroll, it will you will not able to see the progress of that student.
This may happen that a student has unenrolled from your college. In that course, that for that semester, that student has unenrolled for some reason. But the student may still be interested in continuing the online activity. So this enrollment is from your perspective.
So if you want to see the progress of the student, how he is attempting the quizzes, is he is attempting all the questions or he is not able to attend the questions. So here the marks per question is present. Here you have to select the assignment. So in this, you will see the how student is performed. For example, for the course DC101, in quiz 1, there are the 3 questions.
If I am a teacher in your institute, I will be able to monitor not just the gross performance in a quiz. If there are 10 questions in online quiz, I will know what scores individual students have done in each of those 10 questions. Now, since questions will pertain to some topics or subtopics, this will help me to understand what topic is not well understood by the students, so I can use that to explain more. So this feedback we have found is extremely useful when we locally use exactly the same thing for our flipped classroom thing.
So here you can see the performance of student in each quiz. Here the X means student didn't attempt the questions, and the 0 means it got wrong. And this file is also downloadable, so you can show your student. So to see the overall performance of the student, summary of marks. In this, you will see the overall performance of each student, how he is performing in each quiz. This is also downloadable. Now suppose your institute is participating in multiple courses on IIT Bombay X and having the multiple teachers. So here the role of the program coordinator comes. who can manage the multiple teachers of your institute. So I will show you the program coordinator dashboard. Suppose Jay Sharma is the program coordinator. Now, program coordinator is able to enroll the teachers for the course. He also able to enroll the courses running on IIT Bombay X. Now this institute is enrolled for the two courses, demo course and a basic 3D animation using Blender. He is also able to view progress of the student. Here the two teachers teaching the demo course. So I will show you the how it will look. The same tabs will be seen.
Let me just add on to this. This is the role, as I said, is played by the head of the institution or dean of academics or any coordinator that you identify. Because there could be multiple teachers involved in teaching one course, and there could be multiple courses for which your students are enrolled for the online course. So a coordinator will be able to visualize the progress of any student in any course, and thereby can interact with the corresponding teachers, saying at the coordination level, I believe that our students are not doing well in this course or that course, and some special precaution can.
So this dashboard is same as the teacher, but program coordinator will not able to enroll the student for the course. He only sees the progress of the student like this. Under the Prem Kumar, these students are present. And the students are performing like this only. He is not able to editing anything for the student. By using click to enroll for the new teacher, using this program coordinator is able to enroll the new teacher for the course.
So it may happen, for example, that during a semester, one teacher has gone on leave and some other teacher has been assigned. Now this is an institutional function, but IIT Bombay X will not know this. So the institutional coordinator or the head must say that now this teacher is associated with this course. Then that teacher becomes responsible for managing and monitoring all of that.
Now head is the super user. He can enroll the program coordinator and the teacher. So Gopal Rao is the head for this institute. Head sees the dashboard same as the program coordinator. So here the one facility is also available. He want to see the all students' performance in a one screen, so he is able to see. Here he will see the total students for this course from this institute. And here he will see the total performance of the student.
This is nothing but an additional hierarchy level, because who should be the program coordinator, whether it should be dean or any other professor, etc., has to be decided by the heads of the institution. But we are providing the same dashboard, so head of the institution can independently occasionally monitor. All the reports, by the way, are generated in real time. So whenever you ask for a report, it may be produced from a data which is as current as yesterday evening in order to safeguard. So we believe that this would help the institutions to actually participate more. And this is the interface, since all the software that we develop is always released in open source, just like our content. This software is currently developed on top of OpenEdX. But as the chairman has suggested, we will be implementing this interface to the Swayam as well, so that Swayam can also be used for this facilitation of blended MOOCs.
Thank you, everyone.